Give it up one time for the show, where they gon' shoot from the hill. I say two times for the host, give us a moment to sip. It's not for the faint at heart, cause they caught it like they see it. Give me a gunshot for the truth, not always want it but need it. Tune in weekly to get some game from the Montoyas and Reese. Good for perspective, some commentary and a word from the street. Add some humor, some music talking, we done had our fun. But the show is never complete without mentioning Black.com. Shout out to all the supporters, people who keep this afloat, patiently waiting for that new show notification to post. If this your first time listening, take it smooth and just sit slow, and consider this your welcome to the Shoot From The Hip Show.
It's recording now.
Dude, we got the first half of the show.
Oh, we got video. You see the red over there?
So video's good.
The video's straight. So that's going up.
Right.
Damn!
But it was red when we first started.
It was, but he stopped. He stopped me, and then we got off kilter.
Okay.
I did that? Yeah, because you were trying to find some audio, and it wasn't working out.
Nah, but you hit it.
I did. It's all right. We got video. It's recorded, baby. All
right. Move along here.
Damn, that's funny.
Hey, Dallas man.
Hey, man, a lot of shit is going video anyway.
Yeah.
I'm putting this whole shit up.
Davion Irving of Dallas.
He black.
He's accused of stealing two monkeys. Then Davion took them to an abandoned house. He also let a leopard out at the Dallas Zoo.
Hold on. Say that one more time.
He let a leopard out.
How?
He broke in there. He broke in the zoo. He said he's going to do it again. And while he was there visiting one time, he asking zoo employees very specific questions while visiting that one would think that he was up to doing something he was supposed to be doing.
Nigga, how do you let a leopard out, dog? Nigga.
Without getting mauled.
Yeah.
It ain't like it's a fucking mountain lion.
Nigga, a leopard is bigger than a mountain lion.
I don't know.
Yeah. A cougar, nigga, you remember that old neighborhood we stayed in on the north side of Noble?
Yeah.
There was a cougar in that park back there. I used to walk around the trail.
Yeah.
I saw a video of one where this white dude was backing up from it. And the thing didn't really want to get him. Oh, what you got?
The one where it was
you saw it too. Yeah.
I ain't fucking
with a cougar. And a cougar is, what's a leopard? A leopard is bigger than that.
I would have shot the shit out of that motherfucker.
Man, I don't want a regular house cat near me. It's agile and dangerous and things are.
Yeah.
We got a black cat at our house that's getting fixed on right now. Trying to make friends with me now. Because apparently, I guess it was staying there before we got the house. So, I went to go check the mail at night. And something shot off the porch when I was walking to the mailbox. And it was a black cat. And it stopped in the driveway, turned around with them yellow eyes and looked back at me. Not like I'm scared of you or I want some fight with you. Like, hey, can you be my friend? Like, nigga, no and never. But now, because I didn't act on it, this cat is on the fence line looking at us all the time now.
Yeah.
Now, we go outside. And my old lady said, I just saw the cat. Where you see the cat? It was on the fence by your barbecue pit. What? I bought a BB gun for this. And I'm finna use it.
I got a pellet gun in there.
No, I'm trying to hurt the cat like that.
I want
to
kill it.
I'm just sending a message.
You never ate cat before?
No. Not a feline, nigga.
So you ain't never ate Timmy Chan?
Yeah, Timmy Chan.
Okay, what you think that
they might be rat, cat,
yeah,
hat, dog,
or rat than cat. But
you know, on the north side by that old house we used to stay in when I moved in with the old lady
on Sterling Shire,
off in scenic woods.
Yeah,
it had a Timmy Chan across the street from the Popeyes where they cooked the chicken on the float that made it across the internet. Timmy Chan turned into Tommy's Choice.
Really?
Yeah. Same food, but it's Tommy's Choice now.
Okay. You got a choice.
Oh, Homestead. Homestead Tidwell. Shout out to the North Side.
North Side.
Watch out.
All right. Well, Davion Irving's been charged with multiple felonies.
Davion. He's black, right?
Without a doubt.
Davion and Irving.
Brett Favre is
white.
It doing than it thought. And Pat McAfee.
That's real. I felt like we talked about that.
No, we did not.
Damn, like we did. We did some Shannon Sharp shit for sure.
Nah, this is different, dude.
Nah, yeah.
Okay.
Reese.
Come on now, Reese.
Come on now, man.
All right, move along. Shit. We didn't talk about this. I had it here. We didn't talk about it. Damar Smith.
Black.
No shit. He wanted to get rid of the NFL scout combine. We talk about that?
No.
No, but before you say it, let me guess why. Because it looked like slavery.
Yeah. Damn, you good.
I watched the combine yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
I watched the combine yesterday. And I was like, see, we just performing, showing our abilities and skills and checking our teeth. Like cattle or some shit.
Yep. Yeah.
Oh. And I participated in the combine in high school.
Yeah.
At the time, I didn't think nothing of it. But as I thought back on it, it's like, we were just like performing for whitey.
Picked and prodded.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, can't you show me what you can do, nigger?
All right, what the NFLPA executive director wants to get rid of the NFL scouting combine. Said he would rather have
Reed. I ain't never seen a white quarterback in one.
Tom Brady.
Okay, let me say this. I don't see him very much. Let me say that.
Because nobody wants to see them do them.
I don't see him very much.
And the quarterback is not the one.
What happened to that? What's that test? The Wiki?
Oh, the
Wonderlink test? Wonderlink. What happened to that?
Wonderlick.
Remember when that? I remember when it came. When I first heard it, I never heard it before.
That exposed niggas for not knowing how to take a test.
Yeah.
Well, damn. Do they still do it? Because I never ain't heard they about still it do since.
No, nah, I thought they got rid of it.
It's called something else now.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah.
Because the Wonderlic got a bad name on it.
Yeah. Wonderlic, but they still do it.
That's bullshit.
I mean, what's wrong with that?
What's wrong with it is because they made it up to try to make it seem like blacks can't be a quarterback. Maybe they can't answer a damn multiple question.
How
test.
About you fucking study for the goddamn exam and then do better? When they getting ready for this shit, dude, they getting ready for this shit. Instead of around here fucking goddamn all these chicks and shit, you had your ass getting ready for that motherfucking test.
Okay.
Where you think Peyton Manning got Omaha from? He's getting ready.
I'll buy that. Oh, maybe they should know better.
Yeah. Oh,
but knowing how things go behind the scenes, the ones they want, they give them extra credit. They give them extra. They give them a leg up in the shit. You understand?
Okay.
Yeah, you might get the answer to the test if you one of the ones they want. Right. I know that happens.
Been compared to slave auctions.
Lamar Jackson don't have no representation.
That's his choice.
Now what?
He is the representation.
No, that's his choice.
His mama is representation.
Well, that man showed what he can do on the field. He showed it.
And he showed when he wasn't out on the field.
He got hurt. I know. He got hurt.
Yeah, but he's part of the union. So whatever contract he signed, they'll advise him whether to sign it.
They didn't ask him about no Wonderlic score.
You don't even give him that test. You know he ain't going to do right.
Well, you know he good on the field.
Yeah, it depends. You go to playoffs.
And what happened? What happened to what's my man came from Seattle, went to Denver?
Russell.
What happened to Russell? He was like the GOAT, or damn near the GOAT for a minute.
He was never even close.
That nigga was great in Seattle.
He had a great defense, and he just needed to make a few plays every once in a while.
What happened to him?
He's just not good.
Okay.
His Wonderlic score is low.
Yeah. Fucking coach is terrible.
You think okay. so? I don't think that. I think Russell Wilson White got
is right, according to them, because that fucking coach just went from being the head coach having the worst offense in fucking NFL history to now becoming the offense coordinator for the fucking Jets. Huh. How does that happen?
Say that.
You just had the worst offense, but yet somebody hired you to be the offense coordinator?
I think that because Russell Wilson was so bad, and I think that they acknowledged that.
Well, I don't know how Russell Wilson got so bad. Yeah. I don't
all
know.
All of a sudden.
All of a sudden. Somebody got to explain that one to me.
All right. So they were also saying that, you know, they get asked these embarrassing questions. Now, and my, I would combat this by saying, how do you?
You gotta go drain the vein.
Okay. How would you measure a player's ability without the scouting combine? And also, who is making these players join the NFL?
Well, the way
they talk so negative about it, and they make it seem like it's just a horror story. Yet they all in the league. They're making all their money up front in their life. They're getting to screw all the white chicks they want, black.com.
Ooh.
Have all these kids, never wear rubbers. They got these free herpes fucking shots that they can get to get rid of herpes. You know.
Ooh.
Nigga, look here. How you can judge their ability is by the film.
No.
You don't got to do a bunch of testing and shit.
If that's the
case. If they played the game and they got film on them playing the game and playing at a good level, you don't need the rest of that shit. They seen your work.
Yeah.
That's all. No. It don't take no more than that. Maybe a sit-down personal talk to check their mentality a little bit. But film and a personal talk. It don't take more than
film
that.
If it was just film, then the Georgia quarterback would go number one. But people that are experts in the job and scouts, he might even get drafted. If he do, he's a late round pick. He's small. Georgia's playing with five star athletes, so he's gonna look good. Period.
AJ you have McCarron to have the scouting combine for the XFL.
And with the scouting combine and all the film, teams still fuck it up. So why would you get rid of that?
They still fuck it up, and I think Stetson Bennett should be at least a second-round pick.
What? He 30.
He might be fucking 40, but goddamn it.
Good,
motherfucker
though.
Throw the goddamn ball. Motherfucker.
Are you a fan?
He won two national championships. I'm a fan. Like, you go through – you play the SEC schedule, toughest schedule in the fucking country, and you come out of that 2 years in a row undefeated – and winning national championships on top of that.
So why ain't he in the NFL?
And drinking fucking Pappy 23, a $4,000 bottle straight from the bottle. Shit.
Oh, flexing over here. Hey, hold on with the flex.
That motherfucker
is good. The whiskey flex.
Shit, he can.
Hey, Reese, ain't you had some Pappy?
I have.
Hold on with the flex. One more time with the flex.
That says about people that I know other than me.
No, nigga.
I mean, we wouldn't be drinking this Blanton's Gold if it wasn't for Layman.
Okay. All that.
Yeah. So, yeah. Moving on here in the Shoot From the Hip show. There were two mass shootings.
Whiskey flex over here.
El Paso Mall. And there's one in Michigan State.
I know we've done shows since the El Paso shooting.
We have not, but I don't have much to say about it other than stay strapped.
Okay, hold on. There was a
stay strapped. Stay strapped. That's all I'm saying.
Get your stick. Keep your stick on you.
Keep your stick on you.
Keep your stick on you.
He don't believe in that.
I got mine on me.
Well, you know, I hope it work out.
So you telling me if you was in that Buffalo Mall, you wouldn't want to have a stick on you?
No, nigga. I be wanting to know where the exits are at so I can get my ass out.
He knows where to shoot the exits.
Nigga. Okay, let me tell you how it usually goes.
Okay.
Let me tell you how it usually goes.
How many you been in?
None.
Okay.
But I know how this shit works.
Okay.
Niggas carry a gun, they have a false sense of,
that's a different conversation.
No, it's part of the same conversation. Because the killers that go and plan this shit out, they not no gun carrying dudes usually. They just got access to one for the time when they want to go do some bad shit. But the average gun-toting-ass dude, he just waiting for an argument. So he can pull that motherfucker out and be like, now what? That's what the average gun-toting motherfucker does. Oh, I got the stick on me. Now what?
If the Buffalo shooting went down, what would you do? And you in there with your family? You and Heeb, or H-E-B.
And you get your ass a fuck away from the fray. Is what you do. What you think? You gonna take him on?
I mean, goddamn. Okay. At least he'll go duck. At least he'll go duck.
In defense.
All right, Rambo.
I didn't say I was gonna do fucking a shoot down at the OK Corral.
Yeah.
What was this? This summer, there was this white guy. I think it was before the last show I came on. Oh, I think
you know what you're talking about.
White guy was at the mall or and old boy come in there spraying it up. He hit nine or eight out of the 10 shots that he shot it and killed that motherfucker and stopped the mass shooting. Mm-hmm. I don't know if he was just caring just because I can't wait for an argument.
Yeah.
But I'm so glad.
I remember seeing a video of a dude walking in brandishing a gun. And everybody, he walked past a motherfucker who happened to have a gun on him. He walked past him, and the dude that had the gun on him got up out that seat and put him down.
That happened right here, too.
Yeah, you talking about, you remember why, nigga, that was at the taqueria.
Taqueria.
I saw that.
He let off on him. Guess what?
That's the one I've ever seen. Every other one, not the case.
Hey, emptied the clip and kicked him.
Hey, well, he.
Black Lives Matter.
He earned that. You earn them bullets sometimes.
You earn every one of them. Yeah. He has to go.
I saved some lives from that dude with that BB gun.
Yeah, well, okay. I see with the joke. I see.
All right, move along here to shoot for
yourself. Yeah, all I'm saying is,
Lyman said, carry your shit. You just never know. Don't listen to D Montoya's. Hey, how y'all fucked up?
Don't listen to Randy's me, parts. Dog.
Michael,
the Lerner, way I live life don't work for everybody.
Right. That's just you head bump.
Yeah. Maybe.
Michael Irvin was removed from Super Bowl coverage.
Yeah, remember that.
Damn, that was a hotel long time employee ago. Accused him of inappropriate interaction with a female employee. And this happened at a bar.
All he did was compliment her titty meat.
Is that what happened?
He's just like, hey, I like your titty meat.
Yeah.
Was he okay that day?
He's suing the Marriott for $100 million. Said it interfered with his business and his work at the NFL Network. His lawyers call it.
You know he's from Florida.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So feeling the vice.
Well, all I know is Florida understanding. Florida and Louisiana understanding is different than everybody else. Mm,
definitely.
So the shit they think is regular don't fly everywhere else. That's all.
Well, he had two witnesses come forward and say, I don't know how or what he did or said because they was right there.
Okay.
And he got that $100 million last week.
Oh, he got it?
Yeah. That nigga won the case last week.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I know it was he was suing them for $100 million.
Yeah, he sold for $100 million, got $100 million.
God damn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, hey,
he won. Look at that.
Nigga won.
You know how much coke that
nigga on that booger. On that booger sugar.
What finna do?
No appeal?
Hey. I don't know if you know. They just posted.
They
last
used to
week
go back and forth and then he wound up getting about a quarter of that.
That boy gonna be back on First Take.
Yeah.
A little white dust all over his nose.
Shit.
No edge up. No taper.
The old ass mustache. Steve Harvey mustache.
What's that motherfucker? The whispers. This is going to last us a week.
I'm going to bust open some more whispers. We're going to finish this up. We're going to take a break here on the Shoot from the Hip show. Crosby ISD, the first major school district to go with a 4-day school week.
Crosby.
Yeah.
Hold up. Right up the street from here.
Mm-hmm. East side.
Hold up. They going to 4-day weeks?
4-day week.
Yeah. Fridays are student holidays, and the teachers will work one Friday a month. School board approved it, and it's going to start next year.
That's
going to help
dope.
With the teacher shortage. They're already down 40 teachers, supposedly.
Yeah. Well, I bet with this here change, that's going to change.
Oh. And niggas going to be flocking over there.
Hell yeah.
I'm going to send my resume. This OC shit don't work out of my resume going over there.
Man, that's dope.
Freshman coach.
That's dope.
It's not that dope. I don't know.
I don't know.
From a parent standpoint, I got an elementary age kid. What do I do with that kid every Friday?
Guess what?
I'm at work.
Hey. Guess what?
That ain't their problem. That's your problem.
And these jobs got to change also.
My job ain't changing.
Mine ain't either, but fuck it. It sound good.
It sound good. Oh, it's nice. Like, from a teacher standpoint, because I sure as hell want that. I want Galena Park to go to that. But that don't seem like. You know what? With the way schedules are right now, yeah, I only been to work a full week once, and that was this past week.
See? Now you arguing for the point.
And then next week, or this coming week, shit, we get out Thursday afternoon, so there's no Friday. It's spring break. We don't come back.
So you're making a point for us.
Yes, no. It should. Like, you might as well go ahead and go to a 4-day.
Come
week
on, man. Come on over. Let's do it.
I'm just saying, from a parent standpoint, I can understand. Yo, why screw the parents.
Hey, parents, do find something creative for your kids to do. That's why you the parent.
Cut that goddamn grass. Shit,
man,
like that.
While we talking about parents, dog, I saw this dude on Instagram who made the case that he told them chicks he ain't want no baby.
Fuck that nigga. That's bullshit. I think that's a lie. I don't believe that. But go ahead.
What?
That's a lie.
That nigga said, man, I told him I ain't want no baby.
Seven times.
They went and had the baby. Gonna make me be the daddy
he
now?
He wanted to be famous.
No.
That is not true.
You got squirted in all seven of you want a baby.
Yeah.
Hey,
that's some bullshit. People
out
do stuff to go viral. Just like that chick with the McDonald's for the kid.
I'll say this. When my daughter was on the way.
Don't say it, nigga.
I'm finna say it. I didn't say
it. Your daughter listen to the show?
I don't think she might. I don't know. All I know is when her mama told me she was pregnant, in my mind, I was like, nigga, we too young. Nigga, this ain't right. But
man, that pussy was good.
But out my mouth was like, so what do you want to do? Because I knew that it was her choice. Mm-hmm. It wasn't up to me at this point. But in my mind, I was like, you know we both too damn young to be having no kid.
You respected pro-choice.
I can't say that. Right. I had to eat that part because I made the choice to not pull out.
Well, so you made that choice. So you were leaning up in that motherfucker.
Leaning.
I see what you're doing. And what I'm not going along with
Did
you.
Did you see him do this fist like this?
Fist went up.
All I'm saying is you gotta ride with the consequences of your actions. That's it.
So okay.
But in the back of my mind, I was like, hey, come on, dog. You know we don't need that.
Okay, so let's get a little clarity on this before we go to a break, man. Because I wasn't gonna bring it up, but you brought it up. So now, was you leaning up in that motherfucker? Or was she on top of you? You told her to get off and she wouldn't get off.
I'm not answering that question, dog.
This is the Shoot From The Hip Show. D Montoya's, if you notice, he got on his street military hat.
Hold on, street military. Nice.
Yeah, and your boy.
Mama used to say, don't play with a gun.
Look, golfer bro. You know what I'm saying? Y'all into that, go to golferbro.com. And Layman is draped in Adidas all day. He dream about sex.
Yes, sir.
I'm an Adidas dude myself.
Hey. All right, this is Shoot From The Hip Show. We'll be right back.
Bang!
13.
That don't mean shit to me.
It do to her.
Ooh.
Hey, man, I'm just saying.
Go ahead, D. Talking shit, King.
Hey.
Talk your shit.
All right. Are we recording?
Yeah, we recording. Am I fucking around?
Okay.
Yeah, camera and machine over here.
He was being paid $2,500 by Terrence Hatch to kill people. How sad can that be, Boosie? Paying a kid $2,500 to kill people, my nigga, and killed your baby mama brother. It's on now, nigga. See ass in jail with Marlo Mike since Tootie Raw wanna play. Since Tootie Raw wanna play, putting Boosie in jail, y'all. Cause I'm putting his ass in jail. We getting the FBI involved. Boosie is still out here bragging about the murders like he a killer trying to uphold street rules, street codes, and ethics to black children while Marlo Mike is still in jail suffering, feeling guilty. Boosie don't feel guilty about one murder he done committed. Boosie, Terrence Hatch does not feel guilty about one murder.
Bang. Puma did the guy in the mud on her booty.
That Unc if you was jamming, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Who left off bad in boots?
Yeah. Do it look like I don't lift off bad in boots?
Who left off bad in boots?
Shit. Oh, God. Terrence Hatch, nigga. He called.
Hey, you like my algorithm on socials?
Man, your algorithm is nasty enough. Nigga, I swear every social media thing we get on, as soon as I cut on the motherfucking Twitter is notorious, nigga.
I will say this now, nigga. In my defense, dude, even on the TikTok, I swear on TikTok I'd use for food recipe. They put a, they just keep
yeah,
putting.
Yeah, the recipe is pussy. Nigga, I swear, I cut the shit on. I'm just looking for some funny. Only thing I ever wanted to do on social media was laugh. Be a part of the laughter, create the laughter. That's all I want to do. But fucking with this nigga.
No.
We share an account on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. And every time I get on that bitch, every time I get on this bitch, niggas is shaking their ass. It's booty over here, it's pussy over there, it's titty down here. Every time.
Nigga, you know you like this shit.
I mean, I don't mind it.
I don't turn it off.
Yeah. I don't be like, hey, can we do less of this, please? I don't do that.
But no, they be like, but no, Twitter and TikTok got this shit bad. Oh, all of them. They like they,
and it's a lot of black.com happening.
Ooh.
I mean, I go.
I see so much white twat on my timeline.
I go down a rabbit hole sometimes,
nigga. I just cut on. What happened today? Pussy. White pussy, black pussy, dildos. Something cool. Pussy.
Something cool.
Nah, I was on Hussy Pass one day. And like, if you click on the girl, they give you their socials. And you know, now the phones, now when you click, it take you straight to it.
Yeah,
you go straight to the app. Yeah. Then why not? Shit, I'm a fan now.
Hey, no. Hey, what was you on?
Hussy Pass.
Hussy Pass.
Oh man. And then you all see the follows we get after the shit.
They follow back.
Yeah, he follow back. All of them got OnlyFans. All of them. Hey. She passed. Oh damn, my stomach hurt. Oh boy. All right, man.
You ready?
Yeah. All
right. So,
put your pussy lips on Instagram, I'll give you $1,000.
Nah, man, they be, man, it's like, no, I'm telling you, it'll be like one black.com that I like.
Hey.
Ooh.
Hey, you see, and you follow
see,
one.
You see Honey Loaf trying to come back?
Who is that?
Honey Loaf, the chick with the fat ass that was trying to teach, but had a booty all
over. You know what? She don't pop up.
She fell off.
Well, because every time I go on, it's black.com.
Hey.
Ooh.
I remember Honey Loaf because she tried. She was
teaching, doing.
She tried to act like it was really cool and upstanding. But
I mean,
it wasn't.
Hold on. But it was no kids in that classroom, right?
Yeah, it was kids in the classroom.
No fucking way.
Nigga, she was.
You know what we're talking about?
I do not, but I got to teach.
She films herself on Instagram with tight clothes?
Really?
Is that what that teacher does?
Nah, she don't film herself, but she's getting out of education.
The thought?
Yeah.
What's up? Send us up.
Oh, shit. Here you go. I'll find we got a new account. New account. Here it comes.
She doing OnlyFans?
Yeah, she doing OnlyFans.
Is she popular? Because if she popular, I can find her.
I don't know. I'll let you know. I'll get it tomorrow.
Dude, I found
timeline be smutty than a motherfucker, boy.
Hey, man.
And it's this nigga's fault. He put Mr. Pornhub over here.
Nah.
I be trying to look at some shit at work and I'll be like, oh. cut the shit off. God damn.
I hate when somebody. Never mind.
Yeah.
Right, this is
yeah, never mind.
We have a voicemail line. We hope that y'all use it.
You know what you're going to have to do, right?
Unass the Bluetooth.
That's right.
Why are you getting ready for that? Let's go to another video.
All right.
Migos member of the Prince family towards Offset, basically calling him out, and Offset didn't take kindly to that, and he goes to his Instagram live and goes off on that the Prince family. Well, let's listen to Offset as he goes off. Let's listen in.
First off,
here we go. What do you think about Offset's comments on the Prince family? Let me.
The Texas Rangers run Texas, nigga. The United States Northern District. James Prince run shit. He run a bunch of weak ass niggas on rap a lot. He run a bunch of weak ass rapping niggas. Finesse two times, nigga. But he don't run no motherfucking Texas, nigga. Crime Stoppers and Neighborhood Watch Program run this shit, nigga. I'm a part of the shit that run Texas, nigga. The police. So tell James Prince he don't run a motherfucking thing up here, nigga. James Prince don't run a motherfucking thing.
I've unasked.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, nah, there's this, there's this clown. this pig that likes to wallow in the mud. And don't know anything about the movement that the mob ties has put down. This rat, this dirty rat speaking bad on my name, he gonna keep going. And bad news gonna beat him home.
Oh, yeah?
Hold up, dog. Hey, that damn Charles, man. He turned the shit on and off, and he gonna fuck around one day, and what he thought he was just playing is gonna meet him.
It is. He go hard.
It's gonna
meet him. I ain't tripping on it, but somebody gonna catch him.
Somebody's not gonna be with the shit.
Somebody gonna catch him.
And they gonna get his ass.
Catch him, though.
Nah, shit. Somebody gonna catch him.
They gonna get him, dog.
Somebody gonna catch him. I do believe somebody gonna catch
it's
him.
Too many motherfuckers I'm not opposed. That he getting on.
I'm not opposed. I mean, this show was kind of almost created on that, you know, when we kind of started, you know. I poured you something, nigga.
Oh, my bad.
Shit. Oh, I noticed that the pour was a little light.
Well, we got more to drink. We got some single barrel coming.
Hold up, nigga.
You don't play with single barrel.
See, now when I'm at the bar.
Am I right or wrong?
I'm at the bar, I judge
proof.
Things.
Yeah, you don't want to play with that?
29 proof.
Get you something easy.
Okay.
Smooth, ease on in, nigga.
Nah.
92 proof.
These here. Niggas is around here modifying my drink.
Nigga. When we stayed in the same neighborhood, it was different. Old lady could text me, she'd come get you.
Yeah.
And it's different.
I remember y'all left me out in front of y'all house.
That was funny.
Y'all really thought I was zooted. And I really wasn't, but I wasn't gonna fight y'all. So I said, you know, fuck it. I just sit on here and wait for this shit to happen. You know.
I gave a nigga sweater. I think I might
gave
you a sweater.
Yeah,
you
gave it cold out there.
It was cold. Left mine in the cold.
So I went sat on the hood till, you know, motherfucker came through and picked me up. I was like, nigga, I've been way worse than this before. And they concerned now?
Yeah.
Like, okay. All right. You know, I'm not gonna fight it.
Where that first one come from?
Huh?
Voicemail.
Oh, so you unasked the thing?
I said that right. You might even need to go.
Well, we started talking about the drink, dog. Don't do that. Don't do that.
What's up?
Ooh, 125.
Yeah, it's going to be that fire.
You had it before?
Yeah, I got another bottle, but that's the newest one, A123. So that just came out it's the first quarter of 2023.
All right, so now we switch from Blends to Larceny. I want to say that's a small batch that I have.
The small batch is good.
Shit is real good.
Yeah, it's weeded bourbon.
This next motherfucker. Woo.
All right. So this first, the only voicemail we got now, come from the 817. And that's up the road a little piece, up 45, Dallas, Fort Worth area, okay. Up in there. And we know who this is. But let's see what they got to say. Hold on. That's loud, dude. Huh?
Go ahead.
Hey, you guys, it's Keisha. How are you?
Hey, doing fine, yes. Doing great.
Yes, I know. It's been a minute. It's been a minute. I'm sorry, you guys. I have listened, but I kind of fell off for a minute, but I'm back, and I just have to catch on. And go back and listen. But I just wanted to say hello. Happy New Year. It's good. I hope everyone is doing.
It is old. That's right. We did this from the last show.
So we got no bro.
No bro.
Nigga. Damn.
And we back.
And we back.
Hold up.
All right. Quavo and Offset had a fight. This was over at Takeout Tribute at the Grammys. Tensions were high. And there's audio.
What about a flashback from the Shooting Hip Show?
Yeah, you can. That's a big boy. You can hear Cardi B in background on audio telling them they both wrong. Offset denies anything happened. Thoughts?
Let me unask the Bluetooth.
What you think? Did you hear about it?
I heard about it. I don't think they should have left that boy out to tribute.
Like, right.
He was part of the group.
Was he the one got left off Bad and Bougie? No, I was being
that's the one that did.
That was a joke.
He was you know,
they had a relationship, man. If somebody died, man, let this man be part of it, you know. Yeah. You know.
Hey man, there's just obviously just some beef there. Somebody got a problem. And we don't know how deep that goes. It might be some real shit. You know, what I heard was somebody was fucking on somebody else's side piece. And that's what...
I heard Offset fuck Sweetie.
Yeah.
That ain't a side piece. That was a gal.
Well, I mean, you know. She got a made up body.
She look good, though. Oh,
shit. Yeah, okay. Yeah, until you get up under the engine. And see the shit.
Get on some of this single barrel or barrel proof.
You'll be all right. You know, fuck around, be hitting concrete in the ass.
Shit. Ooh, that might hurt.
That's going to hurt.
I mean, I saw where she tried to twerk.
Is it bad?
It was terrible.
Terrible.
Okay. You saw it?
Terrible.
It was bad.
Sweetie.
Yeah.
She don't know.
Oh, she looked good to me.
She was, she was out of line, though.
All right. I played a little snippet, little video, kind of fucked up video as well. You can hear my main man Charleston White.
Damn, boy, look at big boy.
Hear my man.
What's the fastest 40 you ever ran?
Me?
Yeah.
You ain't never ran no 40, nigga.
No?
Forever for me.
Forever. All right.
The fastest one I ran, I fell.
Oh, I was there for that. Well, you got out, though.
Yeah.
I remember getting out when they said, go. I said, I looked over here. I said, look at the whole team. Look at
go.
He got out of there and tried to run barefoot like this, pimping. It couldn't.
Oh, man. Jay Prince did an interview on the Million Dollar Worth of Game podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Gilly the Kid and Wallow were facing a lot of backlash because of this interview.
They perpetuated that shit.
They gave the Prince family a chance to address rumors surrounding them and the murder of Takeoff. Some believe tensions are too high right now and they should have just not said anything.
Yes.
After that, well, during the interview, Jay Prince warned Offset, don't put me in a position that I have to, where I have to defend myself, and that wouldn't be healthy for you. See, and this is kind of old.
He was talking too much, in my opinion.
Jay Prince.
Jay Prince is notorious. He's a boogeyman in the rap game.
That's what they're saying. He talking too much now.
Yeah, he talking too much. It's like dog.
Said lightweight snitching.
I don't know about that.
Well, because it's like you put that out there, so nothing happened to you.
Well, okay, so he's doing a little, you know, trying to hedge his best on the front end. But before this, we never heard him talk like that. Yeah. He would talk at the beginning of some Ghetto Boys records.
Mm-hmm.
But after that, you didn't hear nothing. All you heard was about him, not from him. You knew he was official.
Yeah.
You know, he had some goals and he'd get his record played in the club. That's it.
That's it.
But now, it's like this nigga's on all these interviews and come on.
It all started with what's my man from Fox 26 when it
Isaiah Carey. Went to his ranch.
Went to the ranch, and after that nigga been on interview after interview after interview.
Yeah. He liked the spotlight a little too much.
Yeah.
I think his kids, mainly Junior, putting him in a bad position as well.
Yeah, kids are putting him in a fucked up spot. He probably got to get in front of
it. Yeah, he got to get out and defend it. I've heard Junior ain't long for this world. That's what I've heard. I could be wrong, but.
I heard that.
Motherfuckers in Atlanta keep talking about him.
Mm-hmm.
Well, nah.
All right.
I'm going to let this stay where it's at.
Man. Okay. I got a. This is what I should have played after the break. But anyway, I thought it would be pretty interesting. Let's go.
Let me say this. I don't have a problem with the trans community at all. But this shit is getting ridiculous. If you say as a trans woman, you want to be called her, she, whatever you decide, even though you are a trans woman, if you want to be called her, she, fine. That I'm going to respect that, and I'm gonna do that.
She's from Baltimore.
So me as a woman, if I say don't call me a cis woman, I'm just a woman. You should respect that. I'm not no motherfucking birthing person. I'm not a chest feeder. I'm not a bleeder. I'm a fucking woman. And that's what the fuck you're gonna refer to me as. And you cannot ask for respect while disrespecting women. And that's what the fuck we get for trying to be allies and shit. Look, now they just trying to wipe us the fuck out. Now look at us looking stupid. Dumb shit.
Oh, shit. Look.
Bang! I thought that was
working the buttons over there.
Hey, man, trying to do it.
Who was that? Was that just hilarious?
No, that was somebody else on TikTok.
They from Baltimore, I guarantee.
I don't know where she from. She is.
You heard the dude?
She got braces on.
It was the dude, dog. That's Baltimore all day.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Ew.
All right.
So what is your opinion about that?
I believe she had a lot right to say. I think we talked about it on here, about especially in sports. You know,
yeah, they need their own league, though.
Yeah, they need their own league. Or they need their own lane. If you're into that, apparently a lot of people are.
Yeah.
I don't know how, but, you know, hey, teach his own, bleeder, non-bleeder, whatever.
They are crazy with these new names and new terms for people.
Yeah.
Like cis. Fuck is cis?
Non-binary.
What the fuck is this?
What the fuck is that?
Look here, dog. Do you bleed every month? Use a woman. Can you have a baby out your cop? You a woman.
You a woman.
Dog, do you pee standing up? You a dude.
Now,
Why are we doing this?
I know some girls that can pee standing
up. I seen them squat. I ain't never seen them stand up straight.
Okay.
That ain't the same.
Yeah.
They got that new little plastic deal. If you go on camera. One of those things.
Well, he is looking terrible. I think I can take him.
Okay, 4-1-8-40.
Do you? I'm 44 years old. Do you think I can do more better than a 5?
40?
You think I can beat the old lineman in 40?
No.
It depends on if you worked out or not.
Okay, give me about 6 months.
Okay, 6 months. Yeah.
That's too long.
You can get a sub 5-40.
Like 3 months.
Training, I think you can get like a 4-8, maybe.
Training, yes, but just going out there right now trying to beat these jokers.
So how would I? Because if we did it and we just did a stopwatch, is that accurate?
No.
So I need this set up right here.
Yeah.
So how can we get that? If I come up there after school, you can set it up.
Yeah, I can set it up. Matter of fact, you show up there tomorrow. We got a track meet. We got a middle school track meet. I got to work. Shit.
I might give it a go.
Shit, I'll set you
now
up.
Now I might
the
do
damn
the next
track.
Show, land.
Boy, you be out of this world.
I think I'm gonna give that shit a shot.
Hey, them hamstrings gonna be burning.
Oh, yeah. Burning ain't
if
the word.
If you don't pull it,
yeah.
Shit, my hamstring be fucked up.
Nah. Nigga, we did a combine at U of H when I was in high school, and we did it all wrong. We went to Waffle House that morning, ate, nigga, and then made our way to U of H. And we did the combine, we did the bench press,
you can beat this
and all that. Oh yeah, you beat him.
You beat him. That's still moving for a 320-pound man.
That's big joking. And he getting down there for that size. But yeah, dog. After all that, and I knew I had the shit.
You should have been moving then,
nigga. I ran a 4.5. I got down there.
Yeah.
It was AstroTurf, so it's faster than grass.
Faster than grass, yeah.
Man, 4.5, niggas getting down there.
Okay. All right. Triple extension
Triple X Tentacion.
Yeah, he had a murder trial. Drake was being subpoenaed.
You better put some respect on his name.
Drake was subpoenaed in the murder trial. There's some issues when he was alive. They called each other out publicly. This was pushed by his defense attorney, but essentially Drake was able to get out of this with not having to testify. It's going from some lyrics that Triple Extension accused Drake of stealing in the song called Look at Me Now.
I didn't get you shot.
That's
why are you so?
I mean, it was a nice move by defense attorney.
But I can't believe that he brought Drake.
Yeah,
Drake.
You brought Drake in at awesome. You got this nigga murdered.
He tried to.
Kind of sensitive.
All right, moving on here. Shoot from the hip.
But I ain't do the shit.
You know who Ron Jeremy is?
Porn star extraordinaire.
Hey. Ooh.
All right. He is
Mexican 13 incher.
A judge ruled he's incompetent he's incompetent to stand trial for sexually assaulting 21 women.
Oh, shit.
69 21. Years old. 21. Victims ranging from 15 to 51.
Shit.
12 of them happened about over 20 years ago. All of these accusations happen at clubs and bars.
Well, I have a little bit of a knowledge of this.
Oh, I thought you said you like closer to.
No. But the guy that ran the Bunny Ranch,
he died.
That was the Playboy.
Okay,
Mansion.
The Bunny Ranch is in Colorado.
No, the Bunny Ranch is in Nevada.
Vegas.
Well, it's in Reno. But he died. The guy died.
Yeah, okay. But that guy had Ron Jeremy under his wing.
Yeah, he did.
And then when he died, them allegations showed up.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So homeboy didn't have no more cover. He got to fight the shit on his own now.
That's he looked bad. I mean, he old. So.
Yo, he's 70 years old, 69.
Man, that shit happened, dude. That's like all them chicks talking about. How they were mistreated at the Playboy Ranch. I'm like, why would a woman go to the Playboy Ranch or the Bunny House or Mansion or whatever? Like, stop. If you were even in the presence of this dude, I don't even really want to hear it. I don't give a fuck. Fuck all that.
You knew what he was.
Yeah.
Like, I used to watch Bunny Ranch when it was on HBO or some shit. It used to come on HBO. It used to come on after Real Sex or some shit.
Oh, pervert ass. Was a pervert.
Hey, they do that. They do that. Psh, then they go ask the people walking down the street.
How many people have you had sex with? 20.
Then the boyfriend be like, "What?" All right. Lauren London and Jonah Hill. They played in the movie called You People on Netflix. It was revealed by Adam Schultz on Brilliant Idiots that it actually was a CGI kiss. They say it was because of COVID-19 that they didn't do a real kiss. COVID-19 or not, they lack chemistry in the movie big time. I don't know if y'all watched it.
I watched most of it.
Conversation. Nah, Jonah's funny. Yo, there's a hilarious thing. I don't know if you know if I should share this shit. But
I see
the final scene, they don't even kiss.
Good shit.
It's CGI.
Get the fuck out.
Swear to God, son.
How's it CGI?
I'm there. I'm watching the wedding, and I see them go in for the kiss, and their faces stop like this far. And I'm like, I wonder how they're going to play that in the movie. Oh, they're probably just going to cut right there. But the movie, you could see their faces come close.
Wow.
And then you could see their faces morph a little bit.
Wow.
Into a fake kiss.
It's a little heavy on the tongue.
Most white people do.
So I ball so hard, motherfuckers want to find me. The first nigga got to find me.
Look, niggas in Paris have been showing up.
Bang. Did you see the actual kiss?
No, I didn't.
It looked terrible.
I didn't.
The kiss, you can see it was
still fake. I fell asleep on the movie.
And I will say, going back, well, fast forwarding, the movie sucked. But anyway, the kiss, it's funny. You liked it?
I thought it was okay.
I wouldn't put it up there with nothing.
To have Eddie in there doing his thing,
it was loose.
Now when they start partying, like I thought that was kind of funny. You know, had a little
What's the cocaine man?
Yeah.
I don't have a cocaine man.
That part
man.
Was funny. But I thought in the movie, as a couple, they lacked chemistry. They never showed them building their relationship.
Yeah.
They just showed small parts. And then it was like, okay, they was getting married. And then it was like Eddie Murphy was against them. And it was a bad movie. I
hold thought up, hold up, bad. Cisco.
I thought, I think this guy, Kenya Barris, he's playing his personal life out on screen.
Yeah.
And it sucks. It's almost Tyler Perry-esque.
Boy.
Well, he had a whitish or blackish or whatever that other
one. That's a heavy jacket to put on that dude, call it Tyler Perry's.
Nigga, that shit sucks, nigga.
Tyler Perry's made a whole lot of money, so.
Yeah, but black people fall for anything.
No. Well, yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. Because that Tyler Perry shit, it be low-key, low budget. And we
that
do
kind of be on Tubi.
Oh, nigga, Tubi is bad. I know a dude.
Tubi might be the shit, actually.
I know a dude that acts in Tubi movies.
Really?
You see what I'm talking about? When people say Reese, like, kind of might
nigga,
be.
Nigga, Tubi movies, dog? We can do the Tubi movie.
Nah,
well, we should. We need to do the Mo City movie.
Nigga, you need to set that shit up.
I need to holler at Chuck.
Don't holler at him.
Yeah, Layman, hell, you just like me ought to be in that.
My wife,
your
my
wife,
brother-in-law.
See, I be trying.
Nigga, my brother-in-law and my brother.
I be trying to tell Reese how deep Mo City go with this whole Houston scene. And he laugh at the shit, but I'm like, no, dog. It seemed like all the popping shit that happened in Houston, there's a Mo City variant
connection to it
in it. Mm. It just is, dog. You know, this is one of the blackest suburbs in the country.
Yeah, I heard that.
You know that?
Yeah, I went to a Black History Month walk in the Mo.
Yeah.
And they talked about that.
It's a thing. I didn't know it before I moved here.
Yeah.
But when I got here, I was like, oh, shit.
Oh,
it's going down.
It's going
back. Watch this. In Hunter's Good Elementary. They go, oh, shit, look at my people.
All right.
Boy, please.
All right, that's enough of that, Mo City. All right, YSL Woody, one of the guys that's connected to Young Thug. There's a video leaked on the internet. And this is a police interrogation video looking like, from the releasing of the video, witnesses might be in danger. You know, I think Young Thug's people released this video. And I'm going to tell you why. The reason Young Thug's defense could release this video. Hear me out.
All right.
Check this out. Because if they put it out there, the judge reacted to it. Now, what he can come back and say is, this cannot be used in trial. Take this out.
That's what they said about Gunner's testimony.
I believe they released it, so it was a ploy by his defense team, and they could throw the shit out when trial starts.
Yeah, they said the
instead,
same thing.
Now, if this would have been saved into the trial, they'd be like, but now it's already out there. So it's like, hey, there was a leak. They can declare a mistrial, or they can throw the shit out. He can't use it as evidence.
That's evidence.
So that's what I believe. They saying witnesses might be in danger right now.
This nigga gonna get off.
He is gonna get off.
He gonna get off because
they stretching this out too long.
Yeah.
If he was gonna go, he'd have been gone.
The shit with the whole damn last month, some motherfucker just walked in the courtroom
and gave him some shit. Yeah, come on, dog.
So that he can survive in prison.
Yeah.
Man, this nigga gonna get off.
He gonna get off, man. But all they want to do is put a spotlight on the bullshit. That's all it's really about. They don't care if them dudes do no time. They want niggas to straighten up.
I don't think they care. I think they're just trying to get well, yeah, that too.
I think they just want niggas to straighten up.
But somebody got to go to jail.
Ooh, shit. This must be riveting news, dog.
This is my own show.
You're so excited.
Somebody,
I'm very excited.
Somebody going to jail.
Somebody need to go to jail.
They already been in jail. They just want to drag him through the court process just to show other niggas to slow up on the bullshit. And it's overdue.
Yeah.
It's overdue. We've been listening to all this bullshit-ass music for a long time, man.
Yeah.
Trill.
Niggas been talking reckless and stupid.
Mad crazy, son.
And influencing kids and shit for a long time. This should have been happening, I think. I'm not mad at the whole process at all.
Yeah.
Square business. All
right. Two girls from the Bernie Mac show have OnlyFans. They both releasing revealing photos. One even says she racked up over $1 million in 2 years.
It's two of them? I know the one.
Oldest one and the youngest one.
I know the daughter.
I forgot her name.
I don't know her name.
Wimbush is one of them.
Wimbush. She looked like Dwayne Wade's son daughter. They looked the same.
I actually thought she was attractive until you said this. Don't do that. She is a beautiful one. I think she is gorgeous.
No. That Wade flip flop looked just like that girl.
Zaya just has her hair like that. That's
no, in the face, nigga. They look the same.
Don't you put Zaya on that girl, man.
Man, look here, dog. Nah,
that's the oldest one, right?
Wimbush is her name.
Yeah. He right about
I'm
that.
I'm serious. I saw the shit. I was like, whoa.
For a moment when they put she's the picture up, I thought it was.
Yeah. They identical.
So what do you think about these childhood stars coming on OnlyFans pages?
I mean, you know.
Can't believe people are buying this. You cannot be buying this stuff.
Shit, why not?
People, you buy OnlyFans?
Nah, I don't. Cause my wife might get a call of that bill.
Yeah, you clean it up.
You know what I'm saying? Let's just say my neighbor across the street, or somebody I work with did OnlyFans. I gotta see this shit without a doubt.
I gotta see my
this person that I don't see on the. Well, shit. I don't know it like that.
Yeah, but I do it.
Okay, but if it's just like these girls, like I don't want to see that. And I can find it.
And it ends up being free anyway.
That's what I'm saying.
Nigga, all I got to do is wait for the shit to hit Twitter. With that smutty ass timeline we got, nigga, all I got to do is go to Twitter. And I'm going to see the shit.
You're going to see the shit.
I ain't looking for it, but I guess what? It's going to be right there.
It's going to be under Pornhub under celebrities.
Hey, listen, dog.
Shit.
You need to blame some of the shit on Grizzly. He has a...
Now, Grizzly will.
Highly influences this show.
He will get busy on the instant message, the DM lane. He going to send you some shit.
Hey, he got access to our socials.
Yeah?
Wait. I'm fucking around.
It seemed like it because that nigga, that boy, I get a bloop on the phone. I'm like, look at Cisco ass. Look at this shit. So I purposely don't even, nigga, I can smoke my, you know, stogie and sip my whiskey.
All right, check
but
this
the
out.
Next day, I'm going to go look. I'm
like, Beyonce, sponsor, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. How dare you call yourself a Christian?
Well,
I don't care what pastor you got that is okay with it. I don't care what pastor you got that think it's cool. I don't care what pastor you got that's singing along to that song.
Yep.
They,
yep. Yep. Say it, sister.
You want some clout?
Priest, nigga.
Why you think that man call himself Jehovah? It was short for Jehovah.
Woo! She cooking. And Beyonce?
When a witch has a coven, it's normally a small thing. Witches' covens are normally 3 to 7 people.
She got a beehive.
When it becomes thousands, it's called a hive.
Huh. Say that.
You're a part of that lady beehive?
Yeah.
And
say
you call
it.
Yourself a Christian?
And you following that?
May the dealings of the Lord come upon you. You think this is small stuff?
This ain't a game.
You think you're not going to that lady's concert is not an initiation. You think you're not going to that concert is not a ritual. You think you're not going to concert?
Somebody turn to your neighbor.
It's not a gate.
Neighbor.
That entire concert is a gate.
She preaching.
How dare you?
How dare you?
It's offering time.
Yeah. Said that, meant that, represent that.
May the dealings of the Lord come upon any Christian with a platform that is using mixture. This year, may the dealings of the Lord come upon.
Bang! Now, your wife's selling tickets to this ritual.
Damn, that was a setup.
She sold them yet?
I don't think so. I don't know where she got these tickets from. It was from
I want to go to a ritual. I like Beyonce.
We just mentioned his name, Ali Sadiq.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
His wife, she had him, and her and my wife are close, and so I think she's trying to get rid of him. And so Tanya just put it out there like, hey, we got these extra tickets. But nah, we sure as hell didn't purchase none.
I go to a ritual.
I want
to
go. I told my wife I wanted to go.
It was y'all niggas.
I go.
But then.
I like Beyonce.
Yeah.
He's a great performer.
Is she?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I can appreciate her talent. I ain't going to take that from her. But it's just like Cowboys fans to me. I don't want to be around a bunch of Beyonce fans.
You'd rather go to a row concert where he hold his dick and point the mic to the crowd.
Well, nigga, I've only been to one row concert. That nigga came out and performed that bitch. He didn't point the microphone out and say, sing my song.
That
nigga jumped out there and went and got busy. My wife surprised me with that one.
Hey, sing rapping like a motherfucker.
That motherfucker jumped out there and got right to it.
It got damn right.
And so, I can't, nigga.
1D.
I'm not even. 1D. 1D? 1D, one dude, one microphone, and speakers. Jumped out on that stage and
no, he's only able to do that because he hated on J-Time.
Whatever. All I'm saying is, I can be around a bunch of like Devin the Dude fans.
Mm-hmm. That's a coat. That's a coat.
Row heads.
That's a coat.
But the Beehive. No, I got no place for that.
Like, it's a great concert.
I don't need to be around
that. It's a great concert, dude. I don't want to
be around that.
Take your wife. She might enjoy it.
I'm trying to get from where the frown's at. Your wife don't like Beyonce, huh?
Your wife not a Beyonce fan, huh?
Not really, no.
Okay. No, that makes sense. Y'all made for each other.
We don't fuck around with that.
If you and your wife going to rope, y'all be going to like rap concerts.
She did that as a surprise to me.
Nigga, no. That's not the first rap concert y'all done went to, though.
No, it's not. We did a Devin the Dude one.
Yeah.
But shit, nigga, Devin is my favorite rapper.
This nigga offers nothing for entertainment.
Shit. You better stop it.
What is he start smoking weed on stage? That ain't entertaining. Nigga, Beyonce so be performing, fine. Dude.
Am I 1979?
Yay! Yay! Say it! Say it!
Car rolling, car not stolen.
Okay. Yeah.
That's
what. Watch out, man.
Shit. Yeah.
Devil, not demon, or not demon, hand even. Weed a cigar, blowing sweet in the car.
Okay.
Hold up, man.
That sound good to a weed smoker. I don't get high. I don't understand that.
Do what the fuck you want to do.
Say what the fuck you want to say.
Hey, come on, man.
I'm just saying. Hey, I'm good. Hey, moving along here on the Shoot for Nip Show. MGK and Megan Fox may be breaking up. It's been rumored that he cheated on her with his guitarist, Sophie Lloyd. They got to a big argument Super Bowl weekend. Supposedly, they're getting marriage counseling, and the engagement is not off. Now,
man, can we get these?
Unfollowed him and followed Eminem.
Yeah, because they got beef.
Yeah.
Still got beef.
That's some hate. That's some hateful shit. But can we get these white motherfuckers up out of here?
Now, can we get him? Now, at first, I was calling him aside, but the fact that he was able to switch. He's an industry plant.
Thank you, because that's where I'm going with this. I remember when Pink came out. Pink.
Industry
the singer,
plant.
The singer Pink.
Eminem, industry plant.
And I was like, she came out like R&B edgy.
And she even said that was not her.
It did flip. And all of a sudden, she was like, you know, pop.
The pop.
She went pop. So I coined the term Pink as a verb. So
they
pinked us. Any other one of them white rappers or singers come through, and then they flipped, they pinked us. Jack Harlow, this new motherfucker.
Well, he was a rock star before?
No, but he's a rapper.
Oh, he pushed.
Yeah, he finna be out of there.
No, I'm gonna tell you another one.
He ain't gonna be out of there.
He finna flip if he go, because he ain't gonna stay
rap. What's up, but Post Malone?
Post Malone flipped, he pinked us.
Yeah.
He already pinked us.
He even said he don't like rap. He don't even dress like he like rap.
He pinked us years ago. This Jack Harlow is the new one.
I post.
Pinked us. Gonna pink us.
Lil Dicky.
Oh, Lil Dicky. Now, that nigga funny.
He's funny.
Now, that nigga's funny.
He is funny.
But I don't believe he's writing raps.
He ain't trying to rap, though. He's trying to do TV shit.
Yeah.
But he is funny.
He's funny than a motherfucker.
I give him that. MGK pinked us.
Oh, yeah, big time.
Very easy.
There's no fucking way.
I don't know who likes
this motherfucker. Is supposed to be some type of dope lyricist. Then all of a sudden, he just went straight rock star.
Justin Timberlake is teeter tottering.
Oh, big time, big time. You know who he tried to hit one of the album covers. He tried to look like he's old Western dude just to kind of save face with white folks. But he go get all his music from Timberland.
Yeah.
Fuck out of here.
He chopped the screw song.
Nah, fuck
out of here. John B. Pincus?
John B.
No. Fuck all that.
Oh, I want to hear you say it.
You know why?
I
want to hear you because say he it. Didn't do anything else after that. He would have. And given opportunity, Color Me Bad, if them niggas, John B. and Color Me Bad, if they had the opportunity, they would have pinked us.
No.
Yes, they would.
His wife black.
So?
His wife black.
I don't care.
If your wife black.
No.
Ooh, nigga,
not buying that.
You have indebted yourself into the culture when your wife black.
Nope.
Robin and when you Thicke. Fucking black.
Nope. Nope.
His wife was black.
I ain't buying
yeah,
it.
Yeah, she real care. High yellow and she don't even like.
She fine as a motherfucker.
She's sexy. She is sexy. She is. But she don't like black dudes. If she like black dudes, she don't like black dudes. So she really don't count.
No.
I did
if
watch
John B was given a shot.
No, John B white
if
white,
he
black.
Was given a shot.
John B white black.
Don't listen to what people say.
Nah, look, I think we jamming.
If that shit took off and then he switched up, he'd have switched
but
up.
But he didn't switch up. He kept dropping
he
albums.
Didn't have an opportunity to switch up.
He just dropped an album like 4 years ago.
Okay, it must have went with
it. And it was R&B, but
because
I went to the concert with the wife. And
see, I'm gonna tell you who did pink us that we don't really call out.
Eminem,
Pitbull.
Yes,
Pitbull came out with the jersey.
He was selling
James.
He was dope.
He was Miami 305, this and that. And then you turn your head, you come back around. This nigga got on suits and.
He was still doing the party dance and
no,
shit,
he was gangster first.
He was gangster.
He was gangster first. He switched that shit up. Nobody
that
said
that nigga realized
nothing.
What the money was. Okay.
Yeah. Well, I ain't mad at him.
So,
but yeah.
So what about old boy that went the opposite way? Flo Rida.
Flo Rida.
He never
was trying to be hard. He was
shit.
He was always party.
No.
To me, he was like The Weeknd.
No,
he was a Florida the weekend.
Album. His first album, that nigga tried to be hard and shit.
I never seen it.
Nah,
I watched a couple of videos. I mean, maybe you're right. Maybe I'll give you that because I don't know much about him. But as far as my knowledge goes, nigga was a party guy.
Man, when that nigga came out in 2002.
If he came out that early, I don't.
Yeah, that nigga thought
that's he came out right along with Pitbull then, right around up in there. Both of them switched up.
And now that nigga is straight rock.
He is a rock star.
Tap that bottom.
He just...
he about to get serious in this bitch, nigga.
He just signed... Or he just won a...
It's 132, ain't it?
He won a settlement.
He won a settlement.
Yeah.
A huge settlement.
What was a drink, a beverage company.
Yeah.
Yeah. He won.
Shit.
That boy sitting good.
I don't mind that nigga switching up.
Apple bottom jeans, boots with the fur, That's the only thing I meant from that dude. Other than that, if it was gangster, I never heard it.
Oh, shit, nah.
But I tell you what, he played the smart game, just like Pitbull did. But I recognize that they came out hip-hop first, and then they swapped.
Yeah.
They swapped in a pink. I call it pink, but she ain't the first one to do it. But, yeah, they pinking us, man.
All right. Y'all ready to get ignorant?
Yeah.
We ain't there yet?
Well, we got some real.
I'm off tomorrow, nigga. We can go all the way ignorant today.
Y'all about to make me be off tomorrow.
Except hey. I gotta work. Except I gotta edit this, man.
That's not work. That's fun. Nigga, you make it seem like it's work and complain about it, but it's really fun.
What you got
me thinking is that I'm gonna not go to work tomorrow. I'm gonna get fucked up and I'm finna play some golf tomorrow.
Okay.
That's where you got me at. Got to go to Conroe. Got to take my daughter home.
Yeah.
That got to happen.
Tonight?
No.
So tomorrow.
She got school tomorrow?
Tomorrow she got school.
So tomorrow you
so
go.
So tonight you got to take her home.
No. I get up at 5 in the morning.
It's 5 in the morning.
Yeah.
Go ahead, pull you. I'm going to let you pull you. Now, early. 125. Now, home team.
It's 125.
Barrel proof.
the larceny.
Oh, let me ask you something. Yeah. Barrel proof, single barrel, bottled and bond. Is that kind of like...
Okay, so bottled and bond means that it's been aged at least 4 years and it's at 100 proof. So they've either watered it down or they've done something to it to get it to 100 proof.
Okay.
And they leave it at that.
Okay.
But it has to be aged at least 4 years. It could be aged 8 years, 9 years.
At least four.
But at least four.
Okay.
The single barrel stuff is just what it is. It's coming from a single barrel that... That entire bottle is coming from one barrel. Now, that barrel proof is whatever comes out. Whatever comes out that barrel, that's what it is.
So, this is
what
you're going to
drink. Yep.
Home team, I'm calling it. You're done. I ain't letting you pour.
Really?
After that, it's over.
Smell
it. Okay.
Smell
it. I mean, I got a bottle at the house now.
Yeah. No, I'm just saying, nigga. You ain't finna go home. Nigga,
yeah,
you smell the gasoline on there. Huh?
That's all I'm doing. See, look at my ligature.
Shit, I got to work tomorrow, but I'm pulling up.
Hey, pull it up.
Ooh,
yeah, let your mind be free. Let me free.
Sipping
drink with MOE.
Pull
it forward and pour some more.
Yeah, yeah, hey, hey.
On the south side, we.
That's what you do when you get these most city niggas.
Watch out.
I see.
Watch out.
All right.
Oh, that smells strong.
It's, boy, dude.
Damn.
I'm scared of it now.
There was a video that I really wanted to play along with this next topic, but I'll see if I can get it. But anyway,
ooh,
the brat.
Ooh. Oh, brat. You got him.
Ooh-wee.
You got him.
Nigga, that's some shit right there.
I know it.
Oh, nigga, I'm not finishing that.
Oh, shit.
Okay, no, I'm
going to finish it.
I told you.
I know.
Did I not tell him?
You went from 92 proof to 125.
God damn.
I ain't play with that.
92
home team
to 125.
Home team. I'm not in your league. I know my limits, but I can go a little bit. I can go. And I know when your palate has kind of been set, and then you add something like that on there, that can take you over the top.
Well, nigga, it's there.
Okay.
Nigga, I'm going to respect that.
Fuck I told that. You, I respected it when I looked at it.
Nigga, I saw the bottle. I saw the proof. I was like, but you still got to show me.
Okay.
That motherfucker showed up.
Yeah.
That motherfucker showed up.
Yeah.
Ooh.
All right.
That warmed your chest right there.
Nigga, it's winter time right there.
I did buy it Friday when it was kind of cool.
Yeah.
I thought I was going to sit outside.
And front blew in a little bit.
Yeah. No.
It's warm now.
It's warm.
All right. The brat is having a baby at 48 years old. She's expecting her first child with her partner, Jessica Harris Dupart. Her partner, Howard, is giving birth to 3 kids. Now, she's going to give birth to her first. Now, the brat is the stud, right?
Mm.
You would think.
No, she is the stud.
She the stud.
But she announced this on Sherry Shepherd's show.
I remember when Brat came out in a bathing suit.
Voltified.
No. That's when they tried to change her.
Well, I remember the switch. And she was, I don't know if it was like Moulin Rouge. I don't know what it
was
on.
That was Moulin Rouge when she came out.
She came out in that bathing suit. We was like, ooh, I knew it.
No. You know what it was?
It was her album cover, like her second or third album.
No, it was that boy Tyrese. It was his song, but she was on it. It was, what was the name of that shit?
Mm-hmm. All I know is Brat came out and she was already pretty in the face.
Yeah.
You can say what you want.
Right.
See?
Shit.
No, fuck that. She was pretty in the face.
No, she's not.
She is pretty.
She's not ugly.
She ain't ugly.
She ain't pretty or cute.
No, she's pretty. She's definitely pretty.
No, sir.
Fuck that. Yes, she is. And then she had on the bathing suit. I was like, I knew it. She wearing all these baggy clothes like TLC and shit. Like, no, you hide something up under that.
What do you like? That's what it was.
Okay.
What do you like?
That's it.
Whole lot of foreplay like you want to get it started.
That's right.
That's where it was.
And she, yes. And I was like, ooh, look at the brat.
Yes, sir.
I knew it.
Yes, sir.
I knew it. And then
you know who the baby daddy is, right?
No. Hold on. Who?
Nick Cannon.
Now the Grease put out a post on that. That got some run.
What did it say? I forgot.
It like, you know, I forgot too. It was like, you knew there's a good chance, right?
Yeah, it's a good chance. So shit, Nick Cannon so like
that. Okay. So
you know what's funny? The nastiest shit get a lot of run on our time.
Hey,
niggas is just nasty.
So the brat being a stud, do you think more studs will start carrying children?
No.
Yes.
I don't believe it.
I think they already started.
I don't buy it, man.
And that's just me personally seeing it from the east side of Houston. There's some motherfuckers around there that you like, I thought you was, thought you ran now, the other
I
way.
I will say that a friend of mine, she couldn't say, I can't find a man. I'm gonna start doing girls, and she had got open to girls doing a threesome, and so I guess she had always been curious, and so she was telling me, because you know, I'm a life coach, and
okay, learn something new every day.
So she was a life coach. Hey, well, who the fuck? All right, go ahead. Go ahead, sir.
So she was telling me that you know she ain't dating no more women. She's like, well, I'm not dating that bitch. She's like, she supposed to be the stud. She trying to turn me into the stud. She went acting like the bitch. So what I'm saying is, a lot of studs put on, and but it, when
they put on clothes, sports bras.
Yeah, they do that.
Oh, go ahead, dog. Yeah, something. Yeah, you showed up. What you got?
It's a motherfucker on IG. That's a fucking stud. That bitch looked like she be wanting to give it up to somebody. She
I saw one. That one had that green pantsuit on.
I saw one. And she, it was like they had in the stud outfit. Then they had in the thought outfit. It's like, shit, stud can get it.
Nah. Stud can get it.
Fuck that.
Man, look here, man. You ain't going to defeat Mother Nature. You can do what you want to with that. But Mother Nature's going to show up.
All right. Tip and Boosie. The snitching accusations that were put upon Tip based on a podcast he did back in the day. Boosie was on VLAD. Boosie wound up saying they're working on the album. It's supposed to be pretty dope. A mixtape. Boosie said he canned it. He said he can't because of who he is.
Yeah, Boosie did time.
T.I. found out when the video dropped.
Had a paper, party.
He had the paperwork, which I don't know where these niggas getting all this paperwork shit from. This shit is stupid. But anyway.
Actual paperwork?
Nah, that's what they said. That's what they said.
They can send kites around this motherfucker. Yeah.
So, T.I. said, that's
old
T.I., they went back and forth. T.I. Was interviewed, I think, in California the other day. Or microphone put in his face or camera. And he was saying that somebody misspoke. And he said they'll handle it privately. Kevin Gates and Terrence Gangsta Williams, who is Birdman's half-brother, they've been calling Boosie out a lot about this stuff that's been going on.
Well, Boosie was calling them out. So I don't know what they got to say.
Well, they coming back.
Terrence Gangsta Williams supposedly snitched just like T.I. did on some dead people.
Yeah.
In my mind, nigga, if you're dead and it'll get me off.
Yeah, you getting this charge.
Oh, nigga, I'm telling. Oh, yeah. No. Nigga, I'm telling.
Yeah.
If you dead and this it'll get me on, right, yeah, I'm doing that. Sorry. But first and foremost, I'd be far away for some shit that'll get me caught up anyway. You know, so these niggas,
that's not a stud.
Yes, she is. Yes, she is. She will tell on quick that she don't now, like
she
no
look
dick.
Good.
She look good.
She just gay.
Shit, she ain't a stud. She a stud.
Yeah, that's a stud.
Yeah, she's straight stud.
Yeah, she giving off that masculine.
And she'll put the grill in her mouth. She is fine in the motherfucker.
But she is giving off that masculine.
It's this dude on Facebook. He be like, "Look here, ma'am, sir. Yeah, you shit. Fuck around and find out."
Yeah, I was around a stud one time that rubbed my head.
Hold on.
Which head did she rub? She was studying at that point.
She was coming down the stairs, and I was standing by the stairs. She came across my head with the waves and shit.
Okay.
And everybody was looking like, oh, shit. Because we all thought she was gay. And then she did that. And it was like, hold up for a minute. Nigga, might be a move there. And I never made the move, but I was just happy that, I was like, ah, see that? Look at that.
That was somebody I went to school with. That's,
well, nigga, we went to school together. I mean, apparently. Yes,
but clearly, but I don't want to use her name because she's got a child. She's got a child.
Do you have initials?
I still don't. It's too easy. This one is too easy.
All right, what school are we talking about?
Mo City Middle.
Okay.
Rilla Ridge, and then she ended up at Elkins.
Okay.
She went to all three with us.
So we all in the same circle. All right.
And, I thought she was.
Was she light skin?
Nah. Okay. Nah, she was a brown skin, but all my life now I thought she was, I'll tell you after the show.
Okay.
All my life I thought she was a stud. And then she asked my homeboy out. She was like, hey, when we going to go hang out? Go.
That's what studs do, though. She's going to take that dick.
Wait.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Hey, what year she graduate?
That's still too.
That ain't saying nothing.
She's 98.
Oh, okay, so I might not know then.
9A graduated.
I didn't care at that point.
All right. Y'all in your most city stories, boy.
Night on Netflix for the world to see.
Now, I was man, that shit potent, dog. Every time I took a sip,
that shit was routine, shit is good.
But
that
was good. A small that was added that I don't remember from my comedy special back in December
at the Nassau Coliseum, and now I watch Emancipation just to see him get whooped. And a lot of people go, Chris, how come you didn't do nothing back? How come you didn't do nothing back that night?
Cause I got parents.
That's why. Cause I was raised.
Not to do nothing in front of white people.
I got parents. And you know what my parents taught me? Don't fight in front of white people.
Producer over there. I see what you're doing.
He been watching.
I see what he's doing over there. Go ahead, big dog. I just watched it today, so it's pretty fresh.
This is
his
first time speaking on Will. He did it. Netflix did a live.
He said he was not going to talk about this until he got paid for it.
Hey, he did that. He
fooling with Dave Chappelle. Me and my wife got him a thing on Netflix.
He's about to start talking about it. Got a little steamy in there. I didn't really get to.
Got a little steamy.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
it's another one on the way.
No.
Yeah. Yeah. The way you're talking.
I'm going to tell you what I told this guy the other day. Matter of fact, you know her. Told her daddy, it's scientifically impossible for me to have another kid.
Scientifically impossible.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm not finna ask. Because you leaving it out there for a question. I'm not asking.
I'm going to take the bait. I'm going to take the bait.
All right, go ahead, man. What you got?
Why is it scientifically impossible?
I got snipped. It's over.
Oh, you did get snipped. Okay.
Now, don't get it twisted now. I believe in suppressive fire.
Suppressive fire.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Hey, we land.
Yeah,
I'm just saying.
Just keep them off you.
Yeah.
Hey, do then duck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thoughts on the Chris Rock special? Did you watch it?
I haven't watched it. I saw it come up. I ended up watching something else this afternoon. But I will watch it.
I watched it, dog, and I thought that shit was fire.
It was fire.
I thought that shit was fire, and he toyed with the whole Will Smith thing through the whole thing.
Yeah, he did.
He could, because everybody wanted to hear him talk about that. So he talked about other rappers first, because I don't need another rapper mad at me.
This shit is good.
And so he did that every 25 minutes. He only did it like three times.
Right.
So you could tell it was leading up to it. So, but all the other shit he said in between that was on point and funny. That's what I want out of my comedy. Like, you can touch on topics and not get canceled. That's all I'm asking, man. It's like, dog, if it's a comedy show, don't go there looking to be mad. And he said some shit that might make people mad. But for the most part, it was light. He told it the line a little bit. And he would lead up to it. And at the last 5 minutes is when he actually talked about the slap and why he got slapped and all of that. And that shit was dope the way it was laid out.
He take ownership for it?
Yeah. He said what he said. And he said why it happened. And without giving too much away, he's like, yeah, I got slapped, but I ain't the reason that that happened. You know, he's like, he went on about the about how she had the entanglement. I didn't have the entanglement. You know?
Like, you need to be like old boy from a police academy that used to do all the voices.
Man, I appreciate it, man. I do try this shit.
Yeah.
I do this shit by myself sometimes. Okay. Just to see if it worked. But yeah, he's like, didn't have to entangle it, you know? So it wasn't my fault. I got slapped. And I was like, you know what? He right. And the whole crowd, when he said that, they erupted. They was waiting on it the whole show. When he finally said it, nigga, the energy.
And then his wife was fucking.
Oh, they loved it. You gotta watch it.
I gotta watch it. I'm gonna watch it. When I get
her son's you gotta watch friend, it. With the wife. Okay?
Oh, now, here we go.
I normally would not talk about this shit.
Here we go.
Chris Rock finally talks about the Will Smith Oscars. Vaguely situation.
That's the rule
slap on live TV.
Of show business right
Will
here.
Smith will now have even top content.
More. They would not talk about this shit. But for some reason, these niggas put that shit on the internet. I have no idea why two talented people would do something that fucking low down. What the fuck? We all been cheated on. Everybody in here have been cheated on. None of us have ever been interviewed by the person that cheated on us on television. None of us. It's like, hey, I was sucking somebody else's dick. How did that make you feel?
And he took the microphone out. Yeah. Yeah.
Why the fuck would you do that shit? She hurt him way more than he hurt me, okay? Okay? And by the way, he does that shit. Everybody in the world called him a bitch. I tried to call the motherfucker and give him my condolences. He didn't pick up for me. Everybody called that man a bitch.
That's enough. That was enough right there.
That
was enough. But that's at the end. So you gotta go through the whole thing and get
on that to the end.
Still.
Hey, that shit was dope. She was dope. And you know, Dave Chappelle got a deal with Netflix.
Yeah.
And Chris Rock and Dave Chappelle are boys. So that's how I believe that they have something to do with the whole thing coming out. Mm-hmm. And Dave's in on that. But man, I'm telling you, everybody's waiting for it. They know the story, at least that the slap part of the story. They want to hear him talk about it. He'd been very quiet about it until his special.
To the special.
So now the special got some hype on it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, dog, you got to watch it. I might watch it. I might go home and watch it again.
I'm excited.
I enjoyed it. Like I said, it was Ali Sadiq's Domino Effect and Chris Rock's this one here. The best two comedy shows I've seen in a long time.
Yeah.
And I urge everybody to check both of those out. 100%.
Will do. All right. In closing, Deion Sanders is under a lot of scrutiny. He made some comments about recruiting. He said that QBs in dual parent household, he wants QBs in a dual parent household with a 3.5 GPA or higher.
That's the most Florida shit I've heard.
Defensive lineman he wants from a single mother's on free lunch.
Trying to get it. They on their last leg. Trying to get mama out the ghetto. Mama might not even make it on the plane.
One guy said on Twitter, Deion isn't the only coach that think that way. Just sad to hear from a black man.
Shit. Uh-oh, here we go. Here we go. We got personal experience in the house.
We all want the fucked up motherfucker out there.
Yeah.
On defense.
defense, offense, we don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
Give me the fucked up guy.
Yeah.
Because that motherfucker don't give a fuck about shit. He ain't out there going, huh, is CTE going to affect me becoming a doctor later on in life?
Yeah.
Nah, that motherfucker going to go knock somebody's head off. You don't want the running back that's back there ducking contact. You want the motherfucker that's running
through the wall. Yeah, to run right through the wall for
you. Yeah, we all want that shit. Now, Deion said it.
They're one of the few forms.
Maybe should have said it. He should have said a lot of shit because this motherfucker just recently, last week, went up to the goddamn, oh shit, this motherfucker pulled a hamstring.
Live on the field.
Band director at where is it? Colorado University, and told him he needs to get some more HBCU in him.
Hey, I posted something about that.
Hey, I don't know if that's the right thing to do.
The Drumline movie?
Yeah, I saw it.
I think I saw that.
That motherfucker looking back.
Yeah.
It needs to happen, but you can't tell them motherfuckers what to do because they...
Colorado ain't turning black. I don't see that.
Jeez.
But my Uncle Les is out there.
Shout out to Uncle Les. I like how you try to send me some shit Uncle Les already sent me.
I didn't know he sent it to you.
We fuck with each other like that.
Well, you flexed on me like...
I did.
Nigga, you late. Uncle Les sent me that shit.
Flexing on me now, talking about my Uncle Les out there. You know, he up in the hills. He up in the mountains. Skiing and
man,
shit.
Me and Les was already on that, dog.
I mean, that's cool that you had these relationships.
You know, with your uncle.
With my uncle.
With your uncle.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't call me, but you talk to him every day.
Yeah.
You like that. With your respect.
Nigga. Well, look here, dog. Just know, this is one more instance where Mo City is a part of your life.
Nigga, crab.
Nigga, Fort Bend County. It's part of your life. Whether you want it or not, we here.
Yeah.
You're part of the tapestry of H-Town, Texas. You can't take it away.
Okay.
Much as niggas try to hate, you can't take it away.
All right.
There's going to be some black.com going around on the campus.
Hey! Ooh.
All right. Let's close this out.
Nigga, I'm scared to drink.
Ridiculous.
I do have one question before we close it out.
Listen, some people who've been through black colleges like to talk about the HBCU screw. The mold and the rats are part of that story. Screwed by the government, HBCUs often screw their students in return. And that's the shit we need to address about HBCUs above all else. Because what's best for HBCUs isn't what's best for the athletic department or the development office or the folks in marketing. It's what's best for the students. Big universities have been exploiting black athletes for years, building nice new stadiums and weight rooms off the back of uncompensated and disproportionately.
Bang! Go ahead, you had something.
With both of you being in the career fields that you are, we got a new ATF ruling coming out, or that has come out January, about pistol braces and your feelings on having to deal with this new ruling, if you're for it, against it, if you don't give a shit about it, what do we feel about this pistol brace ruling that's turning over 40 million law-abiding citizens now into felons? I'm about to go to jail.
Yeah, first of all, you're not going to jail. Second of all, if you can't take guns away from the bad guys, you're not finna take them away from the good guys.
Yeah.
So.
I don't even know what the fuck the shit is.
Okay.
And I don't care.
I respect
you. Clearly, yeah, because you don't even believe in having a gun if a mass shooting is going on.
First thing, I'm excellent at shooting a gun. Being excellent.
You got to have one to be excellent at shooting.
Whenever I get my hand on one, I don't got to aim that much. I'm hitting what I'm aiming at. I've always been that guy. Dead Eyes, what they call me.
Dead Eyes.
Dead Eye. Yeah. I got that nickname.
You fucking Will Smith, motherfucker. You
Hey. Going back to what I was saying about that game, nigga, Deadpool is what helped me get through Dr. Strange.
Deadpool. Okay.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, man. you know me, you know how I rock on the gun shit. So I just feel like I'm not getting rid of no guns. You're going to have to catch me. I'm not disassembling some shit that you helped me put together. You helped me because I was fucked up with it.
Yeah.
I'm not changing that. I ain't gonna display the motherfucker to nobody. But I'm not taking that shit out. That shit is dope. And I'd be down if I change it. I like that motherfucker.
Yeah, I feel like I can't even go to the gun range now because 95% of the arsenal has a fucking pistol brace on it.
Mm.
And so me going to the, or now they've made this other shit, this trigger that I have in several weapons, illegal that I'm taking off.
Mm.
It still is kind of like, well, shit, what do you not want me to have else? And so who knows, man, hopefully cooler heads can prevail and get through this shit.
That's so that, what I hope for right there.
Because I don't want to have to get rid of shit just because all of a sudden the rule that you said, oh, you can have it, and then 2 months later change it. That's just...
I remember there was this one time we was in Hunters Glen 3. And this nigga we always fuck with named Rico.
Oh, that's that Mo.
Yeah, it's the Mo. We always fuck with Rico. But one day he got a gun.
Mm. Oh, shit, son. Do we need to shut this shit down?
No.
Statute of limitation on this shit.
Yeah, shit, this shit was 40 years ago. That day. One day this nigga got a gun. He twirling around, playing around, fucking around. Shot his middle finger off.
Dang.
No, his ring finger. Shot it off. Now, I wasn't there for it, but I heard about it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm on Fondren one day. Here come Rico riding a bicycle down Fondren. He give me some dab.
You had to look.
And that motherfucker.
You had to look.
That motherfucker finger was missing. I was like, God damn, I heard the story, nigga, but I didn't see you. So sometimes these niggas get these guns. They got no business with them. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know, them the niggas, they are the problem. They are the problem. They gonna shoot themselves or somebody else.
Somebody else.
So I'm not anti-gun or pro-gun like that. I know I'm good with one. Mm-hmm. But other than that, I don't care if somebody else got one or not. Because I know if I get my hands on one, if I got a problem, man, I'm dead eye.
Yeah, Twitch busting, nigga, get to going.
Dead out, man. I get behind some cover, man, and I shoot the wings off a bee.
Oh, motherfucker, okay. Most Wanted. What was that? That was the name of that movie, Most Wanted, or some shit.
Hey,
Angelina Jolie.
I hate to brag like that because I usually don't. But nigga, yeah, I shoot the wings off a bee, dog. It's not a problem with me.
Okay, nigga,
just here.
Hey, this is the Shoot from the Hip Show. We appreciate y'all for joining us on our monthly episode.
when this nigga stop being so busy.
I'm not busy.
Nigga, you the busiest nigga I know.
Nigga.
Nigga, this nigga went to XFL games, other games, got parties here and there. And it's not hate. But come on, dog.
Hey.
Come on, dog.
I'm always available.
You see, you say that. And then when I hit you, like, well, nigga, I got to go to this game at 5.
Well, I couldn't let my wife go to the tray in the dark. And
it's like, oh, shit, well, I'm old.
No. This is what happened. Check this shit out. We supposed to record on Sunday. I hit him up. He said, well, I got these ribs going. Nigga, when you going to tell me about these ribs? You should have said.
Is that where we going with?
No, you should have told me.
Why? Hey, you see, he already.
You should have said, "Hey, I'm gonna knock these ribs out."
I said, I was 2 hours into some ribs, meaning I probably had 2 hours left. I was good, but you was going to an XFL game.
I ain't hear from you.
Oh, see
that? No. That's see? True. I ain't hear from you.
I said, man. So I'm 2 hours in these ribs. What time you want to record? Well, I'm going to this game at 5. Yeah. That's how that happened.
I'm looking at some shit. This shit is funny.
Uh-huh.
So let me tell you about this right
quick. Pull up that text.
No. So my boy like, yeah, this the one right here. Like, oh yeah, we went out back in the day when I worked. I met her at the Sky Bar back in the day. Anyway, this is Shoot from the Hip Show. 559-825-7465-559-825 shot. Shoot from here 1@gmail.com is the email. Holler at us. We still out here. Yep. We kicking. We appreciate y'all that
ain't
reach out.
Going nowhere.
Make sure y'all like. And when y'all watch these videos, share the fucking videos. Tell your friend about it. Shout out to our boy Layman. If he don't get the OC job, it wasn't for him. It's something better. But we hoping that he get it. Shout out to him for bringing the larceny. Layman has an issue with bringing shit over here and leaving it. Take your whiskey back, dog. All
right, man.
I am not going to be keeping your whiskey. Take that back. The gold, the Blanton's gold can stay. But the larceny can go. Now, it'll all get saved. For real talk, that larceny is good. What you think?
Nigga, this larceny is better than the rest of the shit we had today.
The larceny is great.
It's better than the Blanton's to me.
Ooh, I'm key. I like that Blanton's.
Low key? No, on low the cool? key,
that shit is better than the Blanton's.
Yeah.
Hey, they both good.
No, nigga, this shit
but I have an affinity for Blanton's just because.
Yeah, nah, there is a soft spot for Blanton's since that was the first.
You know, Blanton's is
that I've had
out here in these streets. Low key is the most like the most allocated like thought about whiskey out here. People like to hate on it because it got so popular, but being hard to get now, it's turning into hate.
Yeah, it's like Mo City.
We holler at y'all next door. This is Shoot from the Hip Show. Hit it.
Bang.
Bet it was everything I said it was gonna be, plus a little extra. Chuck deuces out the roof, it's just something we do down in Texas. We'll see you when we hope it's this episode. And if you enjoyed the show, you can definitely let us know. Just hit us up, 559-825-SHOT. That's 559-825-7468. Or you can hit us up on the email if that's more your taste. To shootfromthehip1@gmail.com and let us know your take. Subscribe to the show on all platforms from Apple to Spotify or wherever else you call the slide. And hit us on the web and shoot from the hip. That XYZ. Now let's not sleep, cause it's not free. All support is greatly appreciated. Of course we like the kind of bow, but if it jingle, then it's great. And if you got some love for us and some extra plate duckets, then please don't forget to hit that beautiful donate button. I'm gone.